So this is if you play the Sicilian, your opponent plays the Alapin against you, and you do the Barman defense in return. Very solid reply. After takes and takes, the usual line is d4. But what if white plays knight a3? And I've been getting this a lot, especially over the last year. And it's funny because it was refuted pretty much a few years ago, but 2015 turns out Hikaru Nakamura, the US Super Grandmaster, played this as white against Yang Yi Yu, Chinese Super Grandmaster, 2724 rated. And Nakamura had a crushing win over him, which is funny because it was refuted, so Nakamura was just trolling him, hoping that he didn't hadn't studied the sideline of the sideline of the sideline to know that it was refuted. So I'll show you the refutation, but first the idea of this, it started being played somewhat in 2008, 2009. People were starting to do it because I think because of this idea that if black continues with the normal kind of Barman moves, developing the knights first, then white can get this bishop out here early. Usually the queen hangs around longer, but now the queen's kicked away, really d8's the best square. And from here, white has active piece play and has an immediate threat of queen b3 with the pawn on f7 weak and also pressuring b7. So black can't just develop his bishop. Got to be mindful of this, either protect that first. White to move here. So, for example, after castle, I can either do b6 or e6, but it's kind of passive play for this early in the game, especially with white having a developmental advantage. So, white's done pretty decent here compared to black, and this was the line that Nakamura had his crushing win in. So people re-looked at this, but yeah, it's been refuted pretty straightforwardly. So I'll back up. So after the Sicilian, he does the Alapin, Barman takes takes. Now there's two elements to remember: knight c6, not knight f6, but knight c6 is going to put pressure on d5, which we'll need later on. There's no real white move here except knight f3. You can't get the bishop out yet because the g pawn's hanging, so which the queen will take. So knight f3 will stop that and allow for bishop c4. However, we're not going to allow that. Here's the key move: bishop g4. This stops bishop c4. In fact, the only real answer to this is bishop e2. Why is that? If he tries bishop c4, we have check, and now he's either has to do that, which black won't mind, but if he stops it with the bishop or the queen, we're going to give him double pawns, which is really awkward. Doubled isolated pawns at that. So, for example, takes, he can't take back with the bishop because it's pinned. So he has to take. Nope, not there, but here. And now this threatens queen g2, possibility of nabbing another pawn, and more importantly, these three pawns are, well, those two are doubled and isolated, and this one's isolated, so those are three big targets there, and this is just really uncomfortable for white to defend. And likewise, if he stops the check with the queen, same thing, we're going to take. He can't take because he loses a piece. I'll recapture with the bishop. And obviously can't take with the queen, so again the doubled pawns, maybe just capture here, get closer to the end game and start targeting these things. So for that reason, white does not do bishop c4. And there's also the added threat here of doubling with bishop takes knight. If queen takes bishop, queen takes queen, and again the g pawn has to take it, doubling it up, and you get those isolated pawns. So this is really the only way to stop it, which defeats the whole point of the early knight a3, because that was going to support the bishop here. So now there's two ways you can continue. Well, first of all, from this position, if you look in the database of IM and GM games, at least as of 2016, white has only won 10%, a little over 10% of the games here. Black has won 40%. So a really big difference in the outcome, and for that reason, you could say black is not only equalized but is slightly ahead, although the computers say it's pretty drawish. But no, the results show that black comes out ahead. And the real reason for that is this queen's pretty firmly established in the center, can't easily be kicked. And we're going to punish the lack of d4 here by keeping this pawn to d2 or d3. That makes it backward. And then we're going to take this rook and keep pressure on this file with the queen and the rook, and sometimes other pieces supporting it to keep pressure on this square wherever the pawn is. And more often than not, if you look at, well, I looked at all the victories, all the draws, and all the losses, and this was the common theme. Just keep this pressure on this file. The victories happen when you're able to get that pawn, or generally, when you're able to get that pawn and go into the endgame a pawn up and with a great pawn structure and a passed pawn here. The draws and losses were white just held on to the pawn and outplayed black in the endgame, or a few games like that. Or it was just neither side could make progress. But yeah, this is the central strategic idea. And there's a key move here. So after bishop e2, the last thing to remember is e5. And this really does stop d4. It gets really complicated if white attempts it. I mean, the tactics, there's so many variations. A human can't possibly calculate all the lines. I mean, there's like seven lines that go seven moves deep of captures. And you have to look at every single combination. And if you don't, you may very well end up a piece down. And this advantages to black. There are more lines that black comes out ahead than white here. However, some people have tried it, and it just gets horrendously complicated. But, you know, for example, one line is this. And, well, I mean, there's all kinds of ways to capture back. And if he thinks he'll take it, I'll take it. Well, then takes. And after takes, now he drops a rook. Now, that's just one of dozens that you have to calculate seven moves deep. So people generally don't do d4. They do something like d3, or they might do a different move here. Put the knight over here. There's ideas of putting the knight here. Ideas of trying to get some counterplay, but generally white hasn't been successful simply because white or black controls this file, and with all this pressure on the pawn, his resources are kind of left defending it. And I mean, it's been tried, things like that, and or putting the knight on c4, but black's been successfully able to defend those few attempts. Most of the time it just ends up with black winning a pawn, or otherwise going into the end game with control of the file, getting the rooks there, and cleaning up that way. So e5 is a key move. What that does, I mean, people have played this instead of e5, played knight f6. But what that allows is d4 to happen, and they can actually transpose into a more mainstream Barman. So for example, after takes, they have this intermediate move, because it's threatening to fork the king and the queen. So you got to deal with that. A few ways to do it, but for example that, and now knight recaptures the pawn and white doesn't have a weakness anymore. So this whole idea of punishing him by preventing d4 is lost if you don't do the immediate e5, if you do knight f6. I mean, you can do that and it's playable, and black has had a good outcome from there, but e5 is more aggressive and probably the better line. And from there, you can either castle kingside or queenside. Both have been done to equal success. And castling queenside actually looks a little scary, but the databases show black has not had problems, mainly because white has a tough time getting any counterplay with black firmly controlling the center. So that's possible. If you don't like that, you can do knight f6, bishop to e7, and castle kingside. And again, black has had good success with that too. The key idea here being keeping this pawn weak, that makes it a target, and just keeping pressure on that. White has a tough time here getting firm hold in the center, and for that reason, black has had the more wins here, and that refutes knight a3, and is how you play against it.